So True TV。
What's going on, y'all? It's your boy Jay Jules, and you're watching So True TV, the channel that introduces you to new artists and producers. There's so much talent out there, So True TV is your source to find it. Alright, so what's up, Ford and King?
What's up, Joshua?
Cool. I saw you in some amazing shows sometimes, and music is really amazing.
I appreciate it.
I want to know, what got you started into producing and DJing too?
Mm-hmm. So, I just started to be interested in the whole hip-hop R&B culture. When I'm in Japan, like when I was junior high school or high school, the teenage, 15, 16 years. And I started career as a rapper artist, and then so I was making song by myself, and at that time so nobody making beats around me, because I was young, and so you know hip-hop culture is not like super popular in Japan at that time, wasn't
right.
So nobody making beats around me, and then so I started to make my beat. And regarding to the DJ is the most short career, shorter career than the producer. The DJ is like the right after I moved into the United States.
Yeah.
I just started from New York. The reason is I was gonna do produce. But the producer is just making beats at the crib or the studio, and then if I'm not the super celebrity producer or big producer, so it's, I cannot take the many opportunity to meet the artists or the meet up with the people and the socializing. So I just started to do DJ as a socialize and then so party and then meet many people. And then right now, so I'm working on the, both of them, DJ producer. As a DJ, I check out the many brand new songs, always. And then I'm also doing the online radio on my website. It's called the Stray Hit Radio. Once a month, like almost most of the times, I upload the online radio second Saturday or the Sunday. So you can check out online. FOURDNKY.com/radio.
Great. So when you started, what was one of the softwares that really got you into it?
When I was 17, I got the first equipment, the MPC 2000.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. At the time, so just only 2000. I mean, MPC 2000, and then so made everything. Like because of the that was the my beat was sampling.
Sample.
Yeah, the take sample from records and put the drum and little bit the bass line, and that's it. The more like simple. I started from the MPC 2000, and then after the 1000, MPC 1000.
Okay.
And then, right now, so just Pro Tools, and then so put that many plugins on there with a MIDI keyboard.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yep.
Cool. But are any more influential artists?
Influential artists?
Producers, actually.
Yeah, actually, it's a little bit difficult because, at been doing the other, you know, over 10, 15 years.
Yeah, yeah.
So many songs I like, many producers I like, and hip-hop culture is change.
Yeah.
So it's a little hard to explain as a, the artist or producer, but can I say that top five as a music style of the music?
Yeah.
Okay. So the first of all, so I get influenced by the like 90s R&B.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, I really like 90s R&B.
I hear that a lot in music.
Bobby Brown,
yeah.
Jodeci, SWV, and then everything, TLC. I really like it. And I still like current R&B, modern R&B. Yeah, the 90s R&B really inspired me. And second, definitely the recent trap movement is really crazy, right? And then when I was in Atlanta, so I was in studio with the Maybach music artist, his name is the Mass Pike Mouse, and he got the whole production team, it's called Inkwell.
Okay.
And I hanging out with them in Atlanta, and at the time there's a, you know, Atlanta studios are many closed each, and then the Inkwell studio, and then the 2 Chainz studio, 3XS, that's the other studio that happened in the Bankroll Fresh recently got shot. So that's the near the neighborhood. Yeah, and then at the time I see the they are not my friends, but you know, I saw the TM808 and the same studio that the Metro Boomin also using, Street Access and Inkwell Studio. Yeah, so I saw them really close, you know. And actually, I saw Migos as well. Yeah. Well, now the funny happens. When I just moved to the New York, the day I left Atlanta, the airport in Atlanta,
yeah.
Migos was there.
Exactly.
Yeah. And then yeah, people from the airport said like Migo or something. But yeah, anyway, so I really like the trap movement, and so I saw it cross, and yeah, I get influenced by the trap culture as well. And then definitely I'm in New York right now, and because of my era, so I like the Fabulous. I saw the Papoose Camo, 50 Cent, but I really really like the Deep Set.
Yeah.
Yep. Deep Set is really, you know, because of my era.
Right.
I really like Deep Set, and Deep Set really influenced me. Hit Makers, Just Blaze.
Yeah, Just Blaze.
Yeah, DJ's still playing. Oh boy. I really mean it. Mhm.
Is there anyone you'd like to collaborate like in the future? Like.
Oh yes. I definitely, you know, like the because of my era, I like the Cameron Fowler's, and then also I like Meek Mill and whole Maybach music.
Oh yeah.
But right now, really right now, I really like Daisy Love.
Oh.
Yeah. I recently heard her mixtape or the album the Old Joker Side. I really like Daisy Love. And actually, that Little Dark as well. Yeah.
So there's lots of people who are very strong about the difference in today's music to like the early 80s and 90s hip hop. What is your take on that?
For me, like the most big difference between the hip-hop music and the other genre is the hip-hop is like more like live, life. So hip-hop culture, hip-hop music style has really changed a lot.
Yeah.
But I still like hip-hop because it's the culture, and I saw the whole history. So if just on the music style, if I compare the just music style between the 90s hip-hop and 2016 right now, like trap.
Yeah.
So that's, you know, the melody and then the sound, drum kit, everything's different, like different genre.
Yeah.
But hip-hop is still hip-hop, and then somebody, I know that somebody love only 90s hip-hop, or that somebody like only trap. But for me, both of them, you know, hip-hop is hip-hop.
I see, yeah. At the iStandards showcase that I saw you at, you said some of your inspiration comes from Bobby Valentino.
Mm-hmm. Yes, actually, before, I started to live in New York since 2008, and I spent 5 years, and after that I went back to Japan for a while, like from the 2013, and then 1.5 years I spent the time in Japan, then I came back to the United States, but at the time, so I came back to the United States through Atlanta, and I spent the time 4 months in Atlanta, yeah, and to expand my music business. Then at the time, so I did the many beat battles. One of them beat battles, it's called the 88 beat battle in Atlanta, and then I won. And then at the time, so the prize was the collaboration with Bobby Valentino.
Oh.
And I still have data though, but not unreleased yet.
What is it about music that you love? What is it about music in general that you love about it?
In general, the music is kind of my memory. Like, when I'm listening to this song, or I was with that girl, or I was with that people, and then the music remind me the memory.
Right.
Yeah. What's up, everybody? This is Foreign K. I'm a music producer / DJ. You can check out my music stuff online. My website, FOURDNKY.com. Also, hit me up on IG or Twitter, FOURDNKY, during the Soul Trail TV. Holla me.